What up, guys? Welcome back to another episode of Legend of Zelda Skyward Sword. So, what I'm gonna do now is, we're gonna be going up there somewhere. I believe it's right there, actually. So we can go get a treasure map. So without further ado, let's go get it. And here are some new baddies, which are a lot easier to kill now since we have an upgraded sword. Normally, if you were to try to kill those guys by using the Skyward Strike, it would take like 3 hits to kill or something. 3 or 4, I don't remember. But now that we have an upgraded sword, we can do twice the damage, so it only takes 1 hit. So I found that really cool. Damn it. Get on. There you go. Let's go higher and higher. Oh shit. Not you guys again. I'm gonna throw this bomb at you. Why can I not kill it? There you go. Oh, nope. Right. Ow. I think the best thing to do with this guy right now is to roll it to him. There you go. So, let's blow up this rock. And right away, take out your claw shots. And now let's go this way. Oh, fuck. I did not see that happening. Crap. Alright. So you just keep going up and up. That's all you gotta do. And see what these guys are here? Remember how I told you you can run up their shields? Now watch. And then you can just do a surprise attack and you can kill them easily. In case you don't kill him in time, you just do the process again and voila. Normally you would say it's a waste of time, but normally these guys drop 20 rupees each if you manage to kill them. So by all means, if you want 20 rupees, do it. Die, bitch. There you go. And normally those guys would take like 4 hits. Oh, look at that. There's a goddess cube over there. And we found 20 more rupees. So without further ado, let's get the goddess cube. Can't pass up these goddess cubes. Alright, so you just keep going, keep going. We're about halfway there now, so... Good thing about this area here, it's not gonna take too long. And before we do anything... Oh, we don't have to do anything right now. It's just until we reach this platform here that we have to worry about this bozo right here. So, wait till he unfolds his tail. Grab it and pull him towards you, and then do a fatal blow. There you go. And so with these little things right here, they're little pea hats. So while you see those, you want to use the whip and get them out of the ground. So with that, we can do this. And just wait till we get close enough to where we can reach up this part right here. And there you go. Can we run this part? No, we have to go around. I'm trying to see if we can do a shortcut, but apparently not. We don't have to worry about the Gerudo dragonflies. Oh shit, totally forgot about this guy. So before you latch on to this, you want to use your beetles so you can cut this Deku plant. Deku Baba, or whatever they're called. And then there you go. And before you latch on to the pea hats over here, what you want to do is do the same thing with these bozos. Take out the whip, wait till their tails unfold. Shit. I didn't notice that they take that much health from you. Alright. There you go. One of the easiest creatures to beat, but yet, if you let them hit you, they deal a bunch of damage. Like, two hits literally took, what, 7 3/4 of my life? Like, shit, man. And there you go. Before we go in there, let's go up here. I think there might be something up here. I could be wrong, though. So this is Skipper's house. So this is one of the best areas. So like, if you're looking for sand cicadas, Skipper's hut has one. I don't think there is a treasure chest in here. Over here. Yeah. Just as I thought. Alright, let's go. And so right here, what you want to do is grab your Gus Bellows. Oh shit. Forgot about these guys. Alright. Take out your Gus Bellows. And just spray the whole place down. Now I'm not gonna waste too much time clearing this place out. I'm just trying to look for... There it is. This is what we were looking for. We got the ancient sea chart. This old map details the area as it was long ago before the sea succumbed to the desert sand. Master, I have determined that this is Skipper's sea chart. Let's take it back to him. Master, look over there. Those are pictures that were taken before the, like, to be honest, I think it was like about 5,000 years ago, just around that time, you know? And it just shows how he was whenever there was still water before the sand. Which I found that really interesting. Like, honestly, I would love to see a storyline of Legend of Zelda. Hold on. I detected a bug infestation in the upper area of the house. Oh, those are just sand cicadas, you dumbass. But I would love to see a Zelda game that has, that shows the story of the Gerudo Desert, you know? I mean, it might not happen, but it would be interesting to see a story before the Great War happened. You know, the story before the first Link. Like, something like that. I'm trying to think, is it here? Or is it the other side? So you just want to jump down. There's an area over here where there's a treasure chest, and I think there's also a goddess cube somewhere over here. I might be completely wrong. But it's worth coming to get that, because it's 100 rupees. Yeah, that was the goddess cube up there. And I don't see any other over here. So I guess this was the only goddess cube that was over there. I was sure that there was another one that was over here. Oh well. Let's go find Skipper and move on. Oh, whoops. Ha, you can kill me, bitch. Bitch. See, normally, if you didn't want to get that treasure chest, you would take the zip line from all the way up on top of Skipper's house. And you would be going down there. Honestly, I think that's where I needed to be. Right over there. If I can remember. I'm gonna actually look it up after this video, and I'll put in an annotation so you guys can know if there's Goddess Cube up there or not. And so I'll be collecting that if it's up there. And you guys do it. Alright? You got the sea chart. Now we can finally navigate properly. Let's go look for my ship. Shall we sail? Set sail. Anchors away! Open the sea chart you brought with you. Alright, so because of the sea chart, now our regular map has turned into the ocean as it once was a long time ago. So we're leaving Skipper's Retreat and we're gonna head over here. I believe that's the shipyard. Really. But anyways, let's head over. Just make sure if you're gonna be using the A button that you pay attention to the meter as you would with your stamina stage. Yeah, stamina stage. I didn't know there was a stage of stamina. Sarcasm at his best. Normally, you would fight those. You could fight those guys, but I wouldn't really take the time to do that. It'll just waste your time. So just ignore them. And here you go. Shipyard. Yep, I was right. Shipyard. Alright, just keep this in mind later. I'm not sure if you can do it now or later, but over here, this is where you get to do one of the side quests. And I'm not gonna tell you exactly what you get after it, but this is it. So each location on the island is linked to the others via a mine cart trap. You might be able to get to the back door decided to using a minecart. There's a minecart station over there. You should head to the station first. I'll wait here. Alright. And so... let's just activate this. Actually, I think I'm gonna save. That's one thing I always do, is always save whenever I see a bird statue, just in case, because you'll never be sure what will happen, you know? And look at that. It's these bolos again. Oh shit. Supposed to tell you there's some safety information about using the carts posted on the wall over there. Cart riding can be dangerous at times, so I would suggest you give this stuff a quick read. I have been here alone for, well, who knows how long, years. But I get to ride the carts every day, and I never get bored of it. That's pretty cool. So here's the safety rules, but I'm not really gonna read it, honestly. So as it shows in the bottom screen, you lean that way, and then if you flip the Wiimote up, you have to jump. So whenever you take sharp corners, you wanna lean. You want to make sure you lean the opposite way of what the track is going. So if it's going to go, well, actually if it's going to turn right, lean right. If you're going to go left, lean left. So with that, you gain super amount of speed. It's insane. But this is where it gets interesting. We have one more to go. And it's not through here, I don't think. Fuck. It's right here. So let's get in. And let's do the same thing, but this time it's gonna be a little bit different. And if I fuck up, you'll see what I'm talking about. See that ahead? You want to avoid those. So lean away from it. Oh yeah, I forgot. The jumps. I wonder if I went the right way. I'm not sure if I did or not. Speeds up again. Oh my god. This is just insane, man. Oh my god. Jump. and jump. There you go. You made it. Bird statue. Hold on. No, I don't. Alright. There you go. So let's go this way now. And I think this is where we needed to be at. See what's up in here. Yep, this is exactly it. Master, we have arrived at the shipyard, construction bay. There's nothing in here. With the passing of many years, this structure has filled with sand. I recommend looking in the sand for a clue that might direct you to the location of the ship. Alright. So get your gust bellows. Kill these little fuckers. I'm not gonna even worry about the rupees. I already have a lot. And then blow that big pile of sand right there, and there you go. You're gonna fight one of these bastards again. So just do the same thing as you did before. Just cut his claws. And with twice the damage, it's gonna be a lot quicker now. Oh shit! So yeah, when he grabs you, you just want to swing both the Wiimo and the nunchuck up and down as fast as you can. Not in a perverted way, you sickos. So you want to pay attention to his eye, just in case you miss the swing. See, like that, I should have dodged before I swung. Because whenever the eye turns red, that's when he's about to attack. Crap, why do I keep missing? There you go. And then just stab his eye. Come on, get out of the ground. Fight me like a man. You couldn't even get me. Cause you hide like a little bitch. And there you go. He is gone. This way now. No, I wanted that. So my ship wasn't here. Then there's only one place left for us to look for clues. This could be scary, but we have to head to the stronghold of the pirates who stole my ship. So let's not waste any time. Let's go. Anchors away. Alright. So let's just finish this part up, and then I'm gonna call it an episode. And then we'll start back and then finally get back to the dungeon. So he wants us to go up there now towards the pirate stronghold. tighten up whatever you humans have instead of bullets, and let's get going. Alright. It's pretty cool that these pirates were out since, like, longer than what the entire timeline was, because, like, we didn't get introduced to the pirates of the whole Zelda series until Majora's Mask and the Wind Waker. And then eventually now we have pirates in this game. And I can't remember what other game there is. Phantom Hourglass, I think. I can't remember what else. So, yep. I'm not even gonna bother reading this text, to be honest. Alright, so Pirate Stronghold, save. And then, oh, there's also one thing that I can show you guys that I've noticed not a lot of LPers have shown other people. I discovered this completely by accident. Use your beetle and take it up there to the nostrils of this thing. Take it in, and you find 1, 2, 300 rupees in the nostril. So I think that's really cool about that. Like, my first playthrough of this game, like, I just decided to use a beetle and explore the shit out of this place, and I discovered that all by accident. I bought this game when it was first came out, so yeah, I didn't complete it 100%, I just wanted to go through it. Master, please take a look. This device looks like it's meant to hold the time shift stone, but there's not one currently installed. There is a 95% chance that the same type of device as the ones we encountered in Linnaeus Mines. Signs indicate that time shift stones were used in this facility as a kind of power source. Cool beans. But anyways, like I was saying, like, I didn't want to beat this 100% yet. Like, it was my first time playing this game since I got it. Well, of course, it's gonna be everyone whenever they buy it when it comes out. But I just wanted to play it and see how the storyline goes. And then eventually.